Celebrating Cinco de Mayo, a story by the Read Conmigo team in collaboration with the government of Puebla. Wake up, Frida. At last, it's May 5th, Emiliano shouted. Frida and Emiliano were born in the United States, but their grandparents were born in the state of Puebla in Mexico, which is the reason why Cinco de Mayo is a very important day for the whole family. Mom, where is my General Ignacio Zaragoza suit? Emiliano asked. It's in the closet, Mom answered. Hurry, I don't want you to be late for school. I'm ready, shouted Frida. Let's go. I want to get to school so I can invite my friends, Violet and Mary, to our Cinco de Mayo celebration. Upon arriving at school, all the students looked at Emiliano with curiosity. Emiliano, why are you dressed like that? Gabriel asked. Because I am General Ignacio Zaragoza, replied Emiliano, raising his wooden sword. Remember that today is Cinco de Mayo. You're right. Today is Mexican Independence Day, announced Maria. No, Mexican Independence Day is celebrated on the 16th of September, clarified Frida. On May 5th, we celebrate the victory against the French army who tried to invade Mexico in 1862. Where was the battle? Asked Violet. Frida and Emiliano simultaneously responded, in Puebla. We would love it if you all came to our home after this afternoon to celebrate with us and learn more about this beautiful city, added Frida. Yes, let's go, they all replied. Welcome, said Emiliano. I'm glad you came. I want to show you the photo album of our last trip to Puebla. See how glorious the city is and how it's been renovated. This Ferris wheel is incredible. Did you ride it? Asked Mary. Yes, it's called the Star of Puebla, and it's the largest transportable observation wheel in the world, Frida replied. At the top, you can see all of Puebla. Emiliano turned the page and said, here we are at Forts of Loreto and Guadalupe, which were used by the Poblanos to defend themselves during the Battle of Cinco de Mayo. At that moment, Frida and Emiliano's grandparents arrived. Abuelito Jose, tell us the story of the Battle of Puebla, requested Frida. Of course, with pleasure, responded Grandpa Jose. During that time, the government of Mexico was very poor and could not pay all the money it owed to Spain, France, and England. France did not like that and declared war on them. Back then, the French had the most powerful army in the world, and the Mexican army was much smaller. Miraculously, the Mexican army managed to defeat the French under the charge of General Ignacio Zaragoza. That is why Emiliano dresses like General Zaragoza every Cinco de Mayo, smiled Grandpa Jose. Did you know the Battle of Puebla and the American Civil War were fought at approximately the same time? Frida asked. Wow, I did not know that, Gabriel said with amazement. It's not that I don't enjoy seeing your photos, mumbled Leonard, but my stomach is growling with hunger. Just at that moment, Emiliano and Frida's mom entered. Everyone come to the dining room. I have prepared mole poblano and a table full of traditional candies. Come and give them a try. Thank you, they all exclaimed. For my next vacation, I'm going to Puebla, exclaimed Violet. We can all go together to the 9 magic villages of the state, said Frida. They are beautiful, and it's obvious that Puebla continues to progress forward. That would be incredible. Thank you for coming and making this the best Cinco de Mayo party, said Emiliano. That night, Frida and Emiliano snuggled under their favorite happy Cinco de Mayo blanket and went to sleep, content to have shared a little about their true story of Cinco de Mayo with their friends.